Taming your healthcare data with a data catalog. Hospital systems in the U.S. spent $14.5 billion on electronic health record systems in 2019 alone, according to a recent report in Healthcare IT News. That translates to millions in expenditures at individual healthcare organizations since implementing electronic health record systems to replace inefficient paper processes. The jury is still out on how long it will take to recoup that investment financially, but the benefits of digitized clinical data to research, operations monitoring, performance improvement, and data sharing between providers is clear. And yet, if you talk to clinicians and administrators, you still hear the same complaints that were heard before the EHR era about the lack of information to make business and clinical decisions. Why is that? Well, there are lots of reasons, but two big ones are the sheer volume of data and the complexity of healthcare business logic. Let's talk about the volume of data first. Back in the olden days of the 1990s, hospitals had some digital data, but it was mostly related to billing. The vast majority of clinical data was on paper. To get data from the paper chart into a system in order to do research or meet certain regulatory requirements, someone called an abstractor had to look at the paper chart and key in the necessary data. This meant that only the most crucial data was digitized. Enter EHRs, and now everything is digitized. That's great, right? Well, now we have a new problem. Or rather, we have the same problem, but for different reasons. Data is still inaccessible, but now it's inaccessible because there is so much data that it's difficult to find what you need. It's like you finally cracked the vault, only to find it full of hay. Good luck finding that needle. It's common for healthcare provider organizations to have multiple platforms that are used for serving up reports, dashboards, and analytics. Let's call these things information assets. Each of those platforms can have hundreds or even thousands of information assets. And the information assets are pulling their data from various systems, like the EHR, the patient safety system, the claims data set from your payer partnership, satisfaction survey data, cancer registries, a data warehouse that has components of many of these systems. We could go on and on. How can someone with a need for that information know where to find it in this ocean of data and information assets? Now let's talk about complexity. Even if that person can find a report that seems like it should have what they need, based on the report's title, how do they know for sure? What does that report contain? How are the data elements and calculations in that report defined? What populations are included and excluded? What caveats are hidden away in the code underneath the report? Who can they ask? If it seems like we're overcomplicating this, we're not. Many years of working with healthcare data have proven this out, and if you've spent any amount of time trying to create a metric or report that caregivers and hospital administrators alike accept as an accurate reflection of reality, you know exactly what we're talking about. Here's an example of a metric that is important to every hospital across the U.S., 30-day readmission rate. You have to take into account what the patient was in the hospital for, where they were readmitted, what they were readmitted with. And this is one of the easier metrics. When you get into clinical quality metrics, your inclusion and exclusion logic may have to take into account not just standardized codes, but actual measured values, lab results, blood pressure readings, patient characteristics, etc. The human body and mind are complex. And so metrics and analysis aimed at measuring the care provided to groups of human beings are complex as well. Okay, so healthcare data is complex, and there is a lot of it, to put it mildly. How do you make sense of it all? That's where a data catalog comes in. A data catalog is a platform that organizes this ocean of data so you can find what you need and provides visibility into calculations and data analysis logic so you can know what things mean. It brings hidden assumptions out into the open so they can be discussed with stakeholders and adjusted if necessary. And it provides a vehicle for data literacy to actually take hold throughout your entire organization. Let's see how a data catalog helps accomplish all of this. There are two main functions of a data catalog. The first one is to compile lists of information assets from across the enterprise, along with associated information, aka metadata, about those assets into a central repository. The data catalog accomplishes this through connectors, which are processes that automatically pull these lists and metadata from their sources. For example, a connector for a specific brand of reporting tool might be run on a nightly basis to pull in the full lists of reports, often numbering in the thousands for healthcare organizations we've worked with, along with the name of the developer, a description of the report, the last date and time the report was run by a user, and so on. Other connectors run regularly as well, and all the lists and information are brought into one place, the data catalog. That brings us to the second main function of the data catalog, providing an easy-to-use interface for users to search and interact with that repository. Compiling all of this information into one place doesn't help anyone if still too difficult to find the information you need. So a data catalog makes the process of searching the catalog simple and enjoyable. This means a data catalog not only has a robust search capability, but also has the ability for curated organization of the information assets so an actual person can intervene to organize things in a way that is most helpful to users. For example, top 10 reports for nurse managers, or key oncology reports and dashboards. Once you have a data catalog that's getting refreshed with metadata about all of your key information assets, and you have technical and non-technical users from across the organization benefiting from the increased visibility, transparency, and coordination, you're well on your way to enterprise data governance success.